Geoff Love and his orchestra and Errol Garner's melody, Misty. As this is a great period for award ceremonies, we thought we'd use the occasion in our common denominator slot to join together three songs that are linked by the fact that they're all associated, one way or another, with award-winning productions from 50 years ago. The 1955 movie Love is a Many Splendid Things starred Jennifer Jones and William Holden. Although the title is derived from Francis Thompson's poem The Kingdom of God, the original name for the movie, based on the best-selling book by Han Su-yin, was to have been simply A Many Splendid Thing. Sammy Fain and poor Francis Webster, who'd won the Academy Award for Secret Love in 1953 and had numerous nominations between them, were selected by the film's producer, Buddy Adler, to create a title song, which they obligingly did. Mr. Adler loved the song and thought it to be a great hit. Then, shortly before the film's release date, he gave the writers some very bad news. The film's title had been changed to include the words Love Is. Sammy Fain scrapped his original tune and wrote a new one. Poor Francis Webster reworked his lyrics, and their song became the darling of the Motion Picture Academy, and Fain and Webster took home the Oscar for the best song.
Is nature's way of giving a reason to be living, the golden crown that makes a man a king. Kissed and the world stood still. Then your fingers touched my silent heart and taught it how to sing. Yes, true.
Brooke Benton with that Oscar-winning song from 1955. I'd love to have heard the original song they wrote. Who knows, perhaps it's turned up unbeknownst to us in another form. Here in the UK, 1955 saw the arrival of the Ivor Novello Awards. They were founded and are administered by the Songwriters Guild of Great Britain in conjunction with the Performing Rights Society. Ivor Novello was born in Cardiff and was an actor, manager, dramatic and musical comedy author and composer of many fine musicals. He was, in his way, that which some ladies called a matinee idol, with his extremely handsome profile, and although he starred in nearly all his musicals, he seldom, if ever, sang. One of the top three winners of this first ever Ivor Novello Award was a song written by an old friend of mine, Howard Barnes, known in the business as Boogie Barnes. He was in advertising at the time. Just why he received that moniker is not as obvious as it sounds, as he was unable to boogie, for he only had one leg, having been at London's Café de Paris when it was bombed in the Blitz. His co-writers were Harold Cornelius and Dominic John. This is their song.
A blossom fell from off a tree. It settled softly on the lips you turned to me. The gypsies say, and I know why, a falling blossom only touches lips that lie. A blossom fell, and very soon I saw you kissing someone new beneath the moon. I thought you loved me. You said you loved me. We planned together to dream forever. The dream has ended, for true love died the night a blossom fell and touched two lips that lied. A blossom fell, and very soon I saw you kissing someone new beneath the moon. I thought you loved me. You said you loved me. We planned together to dream forever. The dream has ended, for true love died the night a blossom fell and touched two lips that lied.
Nat King Cole with the Nelson Riddle Orchestra and that highly fancied Ivor Novello Award song, which, unlike several others that year, became an international favourite. We often hear mention of Tony Awards, and I've often wondered who Tony was. Well, in fact, it was a lady, and they were originally called the Antoinette Perry Awards of the American Theatre Wing. The Tony honours distinguished achievement in American theatre. Frequently, multiple Tonys are granted in individual categories, and today more than 550 people involved in the theatre vote in various categories. Originally, the Tony was an engraved compact for a female winner and a cigarette lighter for the male, while today the specially designed medallion is presented annually on nationwide television. In 1955, the pajama game won the Theatre Award. The book was by George Abbott and Richard Bissell, words and music by Richard Adler and Jerry Ross. The stars of the musical were Janis Paige and John Raitt.
No, honey, I do not want a Western. Food is not uppermost in my thoughts at the moment.
I guess you want some coffee, too, huh?
No, it'll keep me awake. Now, cut that out.
What's the matter, lover?
I don't want to talk small talk. Now that I'm alone with you, I don't want to talk small talk. We've got bigger things to do. Let's not talk of the weather or the fashions for the fall. Why don't you stop all this small talk? I've got something better for your lips to do, and that takes no talk at all.
I gotta buy me a dressy dress. The one that I have is such a mess.
Small talk.
Who will you vote for next election? How do you like the stamp collection?
Small talk. I read in a book the other day that halibut spawn in early May, and horses whinny and donkeys bray, and furthermore, the pygmy tribes in Africa may have a war.
No!
Yes! I don't wanna talk small
talk. What do you think they charge for ham now?
Now that I'm alone with you.
Not so a buck ain't worth a damn now.
I don't wanna talk small
talk. Read where the winters are getting milder.
We've got bigger things to do.
And that the teenage kids are wilder.
Let's not talk of the weather.
One of these days I'll paint the kitchen.
Or the fashions for the
get
fall.
Get out and put a new light switch in.
Why don't you stop all this small talk?
Like I was saying,
I've got something better.
What I mean is,
for your lips
I was
to do. And that takes no talk at all.
How do you feel about me, babe?
I love you terribly.
If we both feel the same way about each other, isn't that enough?
You don't know me.
Babe, I love you.
All right. I can take it if you can.
Something better for your lips to do, and that takes no talk at
John Raitt and Janice Page, with Hal Hastings conducting the orchestra of the St. James's Theatre, New York, with that song from The Pajama Game, winner of the 1955 Tony Award. It played there for 1,063 performances and at the London Coliseum for 588, when the stars were Edmund Hockridge and Joy Nichols. And, of course, Janice Page lost the part when they made the movie to Doris Day. So, we've had one Oscar, one Ivor, and one Tony, all from 1955. We'll have three more songs with one common denominator at much the same time next week. Do I need to remind you that you can hear this programme during the week on the internet? All you have to do is to go online at www.bbc.co.uk/radio2 and follow the links to the David Jacobs collection, and I'll be there till next Sunday.
Thank you.
Frank Jacksfield Orchestra with Harry Warren and Al Dubin's Lullaby of Broadway from the Gold Diggers of 1935. That same year, Bert Kalmer and Harry Ruby wrote a song called Moonlight in the Meadows, which was, to say the least, a spectacular failure. But Bert and Harry were determined that the song had legs and could, with a little help from a friend, become successful. The friend they called upon to doctor the song was Oscar Hammerstein. In his very capable hands, the melody remained the same, but both the title and the lyrics were altered, and it became such a success that when it was used by MGM in the film The Strip in 1951, it was nominated for an Oscar. It wasn't a winner, like those others we played, but it's certainly a great song, for this is what became of Moonlight in the Meadows.
Give me a kiss to build a dream on, and my imagination will thrive upon that kiss. Sweetheart, I ask no more than this, a kiss to build a dream on. Give me a kiss before you leave me, and my imagination will feed my hungry heart. Leave me one thing before we part, a kiss to build a dream on. When I'm alone with my fancies, I'll be with you, weaving romances, making believe they're true. Oh, give me your lips for just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Give me what you alone can give, a kiss to build a dream on. Just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Oh, give me what you alone can give, a kiss to build a dream on.
Louis Armstrong with Cy Oliver's orchestra. Having lived for 2 years in Ceylon, now Sri Lanka, when I was in the Navy working on Radio SEAC with Desmond Carrington, broadcasting to the forces in Southeast Asia, I returned to Blighty in February of 1947, one of the coldest winters on record. Having lived in the tropics for 2 years, it was quite a shock, especially as we were only allowed 9 inches of hot water in a bath, the only place in which I could keep warm. My mother and father knew of my passion for American musicals and had managed to get seats for me to see Oklahoma. Not only that, but they managed to get seats for the first Saturday night in April of Annie Get Your Gun, which certainly developed my passion for Dolores Gray. 40 years later, I saw her again when Stephen Sondheim lured her back to the English stage to play the lead in Follies. During those 40 years, I'd always enjoyed her performances on the record, and recently the Sepia label have compiled a set of these under the title Spotlight on Dolores Gray.
With my eyes wide open,
close to my heart with my eyes wide open. I'm dreaming. You're with me now, sharing a vow never to part. Close my eyes, afraid that I'll find this lovely thrill is just a silly illusion. With my eyes wide open, I'm dreaming. Deserve such a break. Pinch me to prove I'm awake. I can't believe that you're really mine.
Recent CD, Spotlight on Dolores Gray, that was the Mack Gordon Harvey Revel song, just one of 25 splendid tracks. Let's have a duet.
My darling, my darling,
I've wanted to call you my darling for many and many a day.
My darling, my darling,
I fluttered and fled like a starling. My courage just melted away.
Now all at once you kissed me, and there's not a thing I'm sane enough to say,
except my darling, my darling.
Get used to that name of my darling, it's here to stay.
You are my darling, my darling. I've wanted to call you my darling
for many and many a day.
And you know, my darling, my darling,
I fluttered and fled like a starling. My courage just melted away. And there's not a thing I'm sane enough to say,
except my darling, my darling.
Get used to the name of my darling, it's here to stay.